Hello there, YouTube. I am Necrostevo, and it is my pleasure to present to you the Victorian Shadows. That's right, for Season 8 of the GBA, the Global Battle Association, I'll be privileged enough to return as a coach of a brand new team. Of course, in the shadows are those that cannot be forgotten, so I just still want to give a shout out to the Utah Jasmine, previously coached by Cooper, because without him, I basically would not have this opportunity to carry on the breeder mantle into the rest of the GBA future. So what can I do as a player in this league to really have an interesting season? And I think the best thing I can do there is just to have fun. I'm here to win, but I'm also here to have fun. It's always my objective with playing Pokemon to really just enjoy it. And of course, it's hard to enjoy things when you're losing, but it's also hard to enjoy things when you take them too seriously isn't necessarily the right way to say it. But yeah, you know, just a good dose of perspective is needed. And when I say that I'm excited about this upcoming season, that does not quite fully capture the way that I just like, I think about my sets and I'm like, okay, let's write all these notes down and run the sets and run the mock battles. And I'm so excited, guys. And I'm also really excited that you're all here watching this video. So I'm not going to waste any more of your time. Let's talk about Season 8 of the Global Battle Association. Victorian Shadows, coached by myself, Necrostevo, the man in the shadow. Speaking of dark and in the shadows, round one, I really wanted to have a team that had a lot of options. I really wanted to have a team that was versatile and functional and difficult to predict how I would use it. And so for me, that means it's time to bring back Tyranitar. Now, for last season when I took over Cooper's team, he too was using Hippowdon. I'm no stranger to using sand, but this is my opportunity to prove how I can use sand. And so we're going to use Tyranitar. That was a really easy round one pick for me, because looking at the other choices that I had, none of the other ones were something that I was worried about round one, at least being picked. I guess the only other one... No, yeah, Tyranitar was just the one that made sense. Especially given my draft order, I was right almost in perfectly in the middle of the draft. Which, in a snake draft, of course, is poor drafting position. But you make with that with what you have. We went Tyranitar first, and in true Diamond Pearl Platinum style, second draft pick was Togekiss. I'm not going to go into too much detail here because I don't like overly long draft analysis videos. And also, I feel like a lot of people inadvertently reveal their strategies in their draft analysis, but Tyranitar has a bevy of weaknesses and you really need something to shore those up, give him some recovery, give him some support, and Togekiss is that Pokemon. Furthermore, in this season of the GBA, Baton Pass rules have been changed slightly if you aren't aware, and so that means we can basically pass any number of stats besides speed, and so Togekiss can pass Calm Mind, it can pass Nasty Plot. Fantastic, different options there. Third pick was actually, so I got sniped. I originally wanted Buzzwole for my third pick. I was going to actually pick an Ultra Beast, which is out of character for me. But since I was sniped, that means I need to pick something that snipes everyone else. Third round pick was Hawlucha. And I went ahead and picked this Pokemon because I still needed a fighting type, and Heracross didn't quite fit the role that Buzzwole would in terms of the bulk and the good synergy with Tyranitar. And Hawlucha is a nice pick because, if I'm honest, I'm never really going to pick any of the Tapus, and having Hawlucha kind of punishes other players for having Tapus because I can just bring it and have the seed activated when they bring it in. Or rather, the Electric Seed, the Misty Seed, the Grassy Seed. Any of those options, all are fun. And then I get an Unburdened Hawlucha. Of course, if I need, I can activate Unburdened in other ways. And of course, Hawlucha's other ability, Mold Breaker, can be very useful when there are things like Mimikyu running around. Up next was a Pokemon that I really wanted to pair with Tyranitar ever since I saw it introduced, and that is Delmize. Delmize's typing goes with Tyranitar incredibly well. And I love the synergy and the ghost and the dark, and it's like they're creepy and they're cool together. Plus, I can totally picture Tyranitar just hefting Delmize around and crushing people with it. The power, it courses through them. Plus, Delmize, he did pick up a couple of new tools in Ultra. He makes a great Z user too, if I end up going that way. He also kind of gives me a pseudo steel type. After that, of course, I honestly had not picked a Mega Pokemon, but I needed to go ahead and pick one because a lot of people were starting to. There was like up Mega Pokemon here and there, and I was like, I need to pick one of those before anything that would synergize well is gone. And so I ended up picking up Mega Alakazam, It was kind of down between Mega Gardevoir and Mega Alakazam. Number one, I wanted speed, because right now, my up until this point, besides Hawlucha, the draft is pretty slow. I mean, Togekiss has slightly above average speed, but the draft was pretty slow and almost 50-50 on the physical and special attacker, so I liked keeping that balance going. So Mega Alakazam does give me speed, but it also has a few different tech and support options, and just that little thing that people have to be wary of in Trace. You have to plan your abilities so that you don't get reverse swept by something. People are carrying things with Beast Boost. Tracing Beast Boost is fun. Alternative weathers, tracing Swift Swim or Slush Rust if people are trying to do that, also fun. So I like adding layers to my draft where people realize, oh man, maybe I don't want to run that because he might just bring the counter attack. After that, Araquanid. I finally got Araquanid and Delmise on the same team, and it's in the same generation where Araquanid gets Sticky Web. What a fantastic day. Araquanid is one of my favorite Gen 7 Pokemon, and with the additional options it gets in Ultra, it is an easy pick in draft format. It already was a good pick in draft format just because it gives you a Scald switch in or a Will-O-Wisp switch in, which you need in a draft format for all the bulky waters. But on top of that, being able to mirror code and just spam liquidation all day, very, very fun pick. I did need a fire type, and I haven't used Rotom Heat, which is my next pick in draft format, before, and I've seen it used very poorly just because of, I think it's kind of like a, it's almost like a middling pick because of its typing, and it's not quite strong enough, and you end up using Overheat, which drops your special attack. But in this specific circumstance, the typing works really well with my draft. In addition to that, it's another pick that is relatively versatile between going offensive or defensive, and then we get access to things like Will-O-Wisp and Pain Split and Toxic and Thunder Wave, all in one Pokemon. So again, this idea of building myself options kind of carries throughout the draft. Granted, my next two picks, Diggersby and Lycanroc Dayform, or Lycanroc Sun, they're a little bit more one-sided because they're just physical offensive attackers, but I need a ground type in order to at least somewhat block Volt Switch from happening. And I also wanted something that wasn't really whittled down by the sand, so Diggersby works out great there. Also gives me some priority. And then Lycanroc Sun, that is something where I kind of just was like, man, I hope no one else drafts this thing because I need to pick up all these other Pokemon first. And some other coaches did go for sand, so it just turned out really well that Lycanroc was hanging around until later, so I was able to pick up Lycanroc. Really excited to use it because really I haven't battled with it before. I've done Tyranitar and Sandslash, I've done Tyranitar Excadrill. Lycanroc is a new one for me, so that one is going to be a fun one. And of course, if I make it a Z user, then I will have access to that fantastic move, Splintered Storm Shards. If ever there were a league sounding name, it's just like the Splintered Storm Shards.
Yes, Storm Shards. All the power. Collect them all. The power flowing through
the power is yours.
The power of the Storm Shard.
I don't know. Actually, it kind of sounds Power Rangers now that I think about it. Power Rangers are cool. Anyways, so Lycanroc is a fun choice. Also, another, I got two more priority options in there, so that's always nice. And then the next two options, again, I was just trying to pick things that rounded out the team. Executor Alolan form. I don't see that very often in draft format. I've seen it a few times. I'm recording this very late at night, so I don't exactly remember where I've seen it before. But you don't see it used very often. This is a good opportunity to get some spotlights on Executor Alolan form. Also, as a Z user,
it gets at least 12 different types of Z moves.
So if I make that one of my Z users, it will be very hard to necessarily predict what type of Z move it would be using. So that, on top of things like Trick Room or Swords Dance, awesome. Really like those different types of possibilities. Then my final pick was Fortress, and Fortress is there just to give me a true steel type, not just the steel worker in Delmise. And I have so many other Pokemon that can switch into fire type moves. Fortress is kind of an easy splash onto this team as well. Plus, that's going to give me another way to remove entry hazards while setting my own. I have so many types of entry hazards on this team. I don't want to rely on Defog from Togekiss. Togekiss should be doing other things most of the time, so that way Delmise and Fortress can focus on removing hazard for everyone else if needed. So yeah, that's the team. I'm excited. I hope you're excited. Thank you so much for watching this video. I normally don't set a nickname for each of my Pokemon in leagues just because I will end up breeding so many different sets. If I set a nickname, then I might choose the wrong thing. But if you guys would like to see specific nicknames for each one of these Pokemon, just let me know. And also feel free to suggest nicknames in the comments. I tend to pick nicknames that are more creative or like have a basis in that Pokemon's lore or reference to a character. I don't like really crude or lewd nicknames, so keep that in mind. I would love some nickname suggestions. It would be cool to have your nicknames being used in the team too, because you guys are nice enough to come and watch us support the team, so why not name a few Pokemon on the team? Alright, so in the meantime, thank you guys for watching, and I will talk to you soon with our first battle in the GBA Season 8. Thank you guys. Have a good day.